Okay, y'all, this is Renegade Biker 24, and I am off to Eureka Springs. I am on New Hope Road. I just had a pretty good lunch with Redneck Biker 9, and he taught me a few things that I need to work on. And he is looking at getting a DVD of an MSF course, which me and him will probably go out practicing sometime. And we'll go practicing some of the corners and stuff like that that I told him I really do need to work on. And he said that the biggest thing is to remember to go going in a corner outside, inside, outside. That's what I need to remember is outside, inside, outside. And so outside, when I'm coming into the corner, going inside at the apex of the corner, if I can get this right, and then it's outside when I'm coming out of the corner, be it either left or right. So that's what I'm gonna do. So this would be a perfect test. This would be a perfect test for me. So that's what I'm gonna do. It's a perfect day today. You can't ask for anything better than this, in my opinion. And next week it should have scattered thunderstorms. So, I might take 23 on the way home, just to see what it's like. Because from what I understand, the pig trail has a lot of problems with it right now. And one of them is, I think it's too washed out from past couple rains. So that's what I've been told. So that's what I'm gonna do. And I have to bring my camel back. I'll just have to kind of tough it out, and maybe when I get to the the convenience store there before I hit Eureka Springs and get me something to drink. So, but anyway. So, what the fucking hell? Okay. What I'm going to do is I am going to pick this up and I go through Avoca, and I'll probably stop at the Rogers Airport on the way back because of the two static displays there, which is a UH-1 Huey and a F-101 Voodoo from Vietnam. So that's what I'm gonna do. So It's basically going north 71 business all the way to 65, and then taking 65 all the way to Eureka Springs. So that's what I'm gonna do, and then I'll just go from there. That Sikh temple has been there for a while. I've never been in there. I bet they're pretty accepting. And I'm not one to judge when it comes to religion, because that's just not my place doing. But anyway, like I said, I'm going to cut it off here, and I will talk to you guys in a little bit. So anyway, it's Renegade Biker 24, and I'll pick it up when I go through Avoca. Okay, y'all, it's Renegade Biker 24 again, going by Rogers Airport. And we'll be going by the static display of the F-101 Voodoo, which you'll see up here on my left, and also the UH-1 Huey, which are both used in Vietnam. The F-101 was mainly, I think, a fighter attack aircraft, and the UH-1 Huey, which is used as a troop transport and a gunship. As you can see, that's right there. Right there. So that's the static display. So. That's what they did to honor those Vietnam vets, which, by the way, Vietnam vets I've met are pretty cool people, and granted, when that war happened, I was just a little baby. But the way they were treated when they got home, that really did suck. It really did suck. They didn't deserve that. They didn't deserve to be spit on. They didn't deserve to be called baby killers or anything like that. They didn't need that. But at the same time, I find it interesting that those that came back from Iraq, in the Iraq War, and I've talked to one of the veterans, and he has said that when he went to Chicago on his way back, they were doing the same thing. They were spitting on him and calling him baby killer and this and that. And yet, when he flew into Texas, it was like a whole different world. It was a whole different world for him. A whole different world. They treated him like almost a king. And even in Iraq, he was saying that he was treated with almost like royalty when he was in Iraq, where one of the, I think it was the mayor, had given him a scimitar, and the scimitar was called Justice. So that's just something that thought you guys might be interested to know about. So, but anyway, that's what I found out. So, anyway, I'm gonna pick this up. I'll pick this up at a different spot, so I will talk to you guys in a bit. Okay, y'all, this is a place I just passed, and that's the convenience store there. Now I'm still on 62. Not on 65. I made a mistake there. It's 62, not 65. Now, I just gotta remember, outside, inside, outside. So outside, going into the curve, inside, and going in the apex, and outside, when I come out. So, that's what I gotta remember. Outside, inside, outside. According to Redneck Biker 109. I haven't really gotten on the brake that much. Because I've been riding the brake. But, if I find it to be uncomfortable, I will either slow down or apply the brake. So this is the tricky part for me is this curve here. So just have to remember outside, inside, outside. Yeah, I keep saying that over and over in my mind when approaching a curve. I've been doing good so far. So, I think I'm doing pretty good. I'm in Gateway. Population 405 people. And make that 406 now. As you see, I didn't put my arm down. Okay. Now, I just gotta remember, outside, inside, outside. Okay, there we go over the curve. So, in the outside lane, and then go toward the inside. Seems to be a sweeping turn here. So, I gotta remember, outside, inside, outside. Or OIO. OIO. I just put an H in there. So, and it spells Ohio. Anyway, that's useless information. So, alright, so now I'm going to 45, then down to 35. And here comes some more practice for me up ahead. So let's see if I can do this right. Now it's going to be 20 miles an hour. So outside, inside. Okay, Eureka Springs. Just keep going this way. Miles on E62. Okay. All right. Well, I think I'm getting the hang of it now. Eureka Springs is a perfect place, and the roads leading up to Eureka Springs is a perfect place to practice outside, inside, outside. Okay, here comes another curve. It's a sweeping curve, so let's see here. Outside, inside. Outside. Alright. And outside. Oh, I misjudged that. Okay, I misjudged that. So. Alright, still working on it. But, and still working on it. So, I'll pick it up here in a little bit because it's about to get crooked and steep. So, I'll pick it up in a little bit.